And this, guys, is why this is going to be an awesome series. Hey guys, welcome to episode 6. So we're just going to start right from where we left off and we're going to go exploring. Don't want to waste too much time, so let's just head there immediately. I have my empty jars on me, have clothes on me, awesome. Should actually take this off. Let's just put the clothes away for now. I'm going to keep the mining armor for in case we find a shop or something that's too dark inside. Also, I'm going to keep my wrench on me so we can dismantle any workbenches we might come across. Hopefully, we come across some. So the new internet we got finally throttled. At about 350 gigs, all of a sudden, we're getting 4 megabytes per second instead of the 50. I'll definitely need to be more careful during Alpha 16 recordings. Don't want to do streamings when the internet is too slow. Just need to remember to gather some yucca. Is it yucca or yucca? For me, because it's a U, I say yucca. I think I'm just going to run in a straight path, and then anything I come across, I'll take. Anything in my path. Otherwise, I'm going to run zigzags, and I'm never going to get to where I want to go. At least I'm finding awesome loot. As soon as my construction skill gets to level 20, I want to purchase that concrete mixing skill. I think right after this episode, I'm actually going to go and dig up a few episodes. I'm going to dig up that gravel so we can start creating our own concrete mix. Like I said, we're most likely going to be facing the day 7 horde in the hotel, or from the hotel. I just wish I could play this game with other people. I'm actually thinking of perhaps, I'm gonna see how much the server costs. And then, who knows, perhaps I'll open my own server and all the subs can play with me. That would be awesome. But I actually only want to do that when I reach about 500 subs. At the moment, I don't have that many subs. Now this is a pit. Let's just do this. Pit cave. We'll come to all these caves later on when we need resources. Especially since this is a desert biome, I'll need more shale. It's nice since we're so close to the desert this time. I actually want to see what the damage on my machete is, because I think I'm going to be able to swap these two out. Only problem is this is easy to and cheap to replace, but the machete is expensive. I have this feeling that I'm getting close to a town. Usually at the top of one of these there's a town. Unfortunately, I can't even wear my mining helmet because it's too hot. Come on! I hope they fix that in Alpha 16. Don't want to take too long killing zombies and stuff, even though killing zombies helps me level up quite a bit, and I need to gain levels fast. Also guys, I need your input. As I said, this is actually a test series for Alpha 16. And I'm testing out the music. Tell me, do you guys like the music I'm using at the moment? Can you suggest better music for me? Also, this box you see around my face, do you think it should stay blue or do I need to use a different color? I need all of this input from you guys so that I'm sure to deliver proper content in Alpha 16. This usually means there's a town nearby, so I hope I'm right. At least if there's a town, we can start some looting. Let's make some yucca juice. And then I'm gonna put on the mining helmet and just use the yucca juice to cool off. Also need to keep track of all these roads, since I can later then come explore them and see if there's more traders in the area. I think if the road takes a turn to the left, I'm gonna take it and see what's on the very top of this hill. Unless there's nothing on the seal, that would suck. We just go this way and see if we find something. I want to see if I can see a town from up here. It's the best way to find a town is get the highest viewpoint. Doesn't seem to be anything flat in that direction, so let's just keep going. It would be awesome if we can find a desert town to loot. It's been a while since I've done anything in the desert. So while we're in this view, let's just quickly see. Entity damage 31, entity damage 12. So technically this is better. I'm just going to make some space and then keep going. Oh, the Yuka juice is taking up most of the queue. And I'm already overeating. Let's see how good this Yuka juice is. I just find it strange that you can't see any town in line of sight. Guys, I'm sorry if I sound a bit weird. I'm just very tired after today. I actually have a back problem and I've been walking the whole day, so I'm just so damn tired. That's why sometimes, even though I'm... Oh, damn it. Come on. Even though I know what I want to say, I just get confused. But at least our temperature is going down, so that's a good thing. What the hell, I could have sworn I hit her head. I should definitely wait until I have a better quality weapon before I try that again. Don't want to die off the stupidest of things. We'll just drop a few things and make some space over here. We can upgrade this again. Let's grab that, and let's just quickly see what we can swap out of here. 74? Well, but this one's better quality, or better health. This one makes a lot of difference, so let's just do that, and then scrap this. It almost feels like the range for the melee weapons is lower. Like, I think I'm hitting them, but I'm coming short. Anyways, like I said, I intend to, after this episode, do some digging for that gravel. And then hopefully... Nothing flat over there. I'm gonna dig up all that gravel and then hopefully have enough for the cement mix. But it's gonna take a few days off camera. Come on, there has to be a town close by. Let's check over this ridge. Seems to be only lake over here. Yep, nothing flat. Damn it. Don't break a leg, don't hurt yourself, and keep going. I hope to find a town or at least another intersection before nightfall, so I want to spend the night there. I don't want to run back all the way to the base, only to run back this way when it's daylight again. Ooh, another chicken. Probably going to be gone by the time I get there. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Chainsaw blade, don't need it. Please tell me that's not destroyed biome over there. Yep, by the time I get here, there's no sign of the chicken. Damn, I'm already eating up. I need to drink something again. And I can't drink anything. Great. No, I should be able to drink. Because it's so hot, my water needs to go down faster. That's weird. Well, seems that there's no desert town. Because we're already exiting the desert. I think there should still be some roads left in the desert. I'm just going to keep going and see where this leads us. Just want to see that maybe we can circle back. This road... Nope. Who knows, if I take a right, maybe we get into another desert biome. Guys, tell me what you think of the series so far. Is it a bit boring? Do you enjoy it? I want your input so I can actually make these videos better. Doesn't help me just playing and you watching and I don't get any feedback because then the videos are going to stay the same. So if you guys have a problem with something I do or you think I'm doing well, please let me know. Ooh, looks like I found a town. Or is this just another intersection? Please tell me it's not just another intersection. It's just another intersection. I think I'm gonna make a drop chest over here. First I need to get the attention of all these zombies, and I think that's another gas station, so hopefully that has our workbench that we're looking for. It should have it since it's the smaller gas station. Ooh, even a bunker, awesome. I think we're gonna stay in this intersection and do some looting. Just wanna make sure they don't spawn behind me. Don't wanna waste all my ammo. Just please tell me there's no zombie sneaking up on me. I need better quality weapons. Come on, come on, come on. You'd be awesome if it was powerful enough to go through the heads. Damn, bad shot. I can't afford to waste too many arrows. Even though I can make a few more, I just don't have the time to go stone gathering. Come on, bad shot. Come on, come on, come on, come on. I want to get this over with before nightfall. At least if this intersection gets cleared out, I'll be safe. And at least now I have an iron axe, so going through the hotel during night will be a lot faster. So let's just drink one of these, and then we have a painkiller for later on if we need more space, or if we need to drink again. Just eat the painkiller and it'll open up some water for you. Okay, let's just quickly loot all these corpses and then make a drop chest. I think I'm gonna make the drop chest in the hotel. I'm gonna throw away everything I don't need at the moment. While we're at it, let's just make a bit more yucca juice to open up a few slots. Definitely want to get through this area before nightfall, or at least make sure there's no zombies left. Then we can do our looting in peace during the night. Maybe run out of space. Should actually go and make that drop chest first. I'll be over the moon if this place has a workbench. If it has a workbench, we're gonna go back during the morning, or at when the clock strikes morning. I don't know how to say it. We're just gonna go back and we're gonna put down our workbench and start making better items. Or at least during the night, I can make better items over here. But let's just quickly make our storage chest and then put these in behind. Okay, so everything we don't need at the moment, I'm gonna keep all the ammo on me. You could use, I'm still making eggs, I can put away. Feathers I'll keep on me for now. This I need. Don't need. Okay, I'm gonna keep one Euclid juice on me and then the wrench on me. Okay, that should be it for now. Let's just mark this on the map so we don't forget. And now to quickly clear out the area. For a moment I thought this was a zombie. I wonder if there's an opening on this side. I actually also need to take down a boulder. I don't have the time for that. I need the boulder for my stone axes. At least there's a boulder behind the hotel, just need to remember that. Okay, let's run around here quickly. I'm gonna loot this during the night, guys, so for now I just make sure that there's nothing to impede our looting during the night. Please tell me this has a workbench. Also, there's more gravel over here, so when we run out of gravel on the other side, we can come dig here. That almost sounds like a horde. Where is it? Inside? Come on. It's almost nightfall. Yes, workbench, awesome. Damn it, John, come on, hit them. Come on! Damn it, these guys are hard to hit. Okay, so there's a workbench over here. I think during the night, I should actually make my stone axes here and then pick it up afterwards. Just need to loot this whole place first and make sure that there's no zombies chasing me. Just please tell me I'm safe during the night. I can do some awesome looting. You don't always call looting awesome until you find a place like this that gives you so much. I just need to remember that there's a workbench, but I don't think I'll forget to take this. Ooh, running out of space already. I'm actually glad that there's not too many landmines in the game. I remember when Alpha 15 came out, the thought of landmines had everyone upset, but it actually worked out quite well in the end. Only certain areas have them, and it's only the extremely difficult areas. It's not like you run into a gas station and all of a sudden die from a landmine. So I'm just going to loot that skate park over there, and then during the night I'm going to cut away and loot that off camera. You know what, let's first just drop all these off so that we at least have space to do some work. You always say you can't wait for something, but I can wait for Alpha 16. Just the thought of the sleeper zombies makes me a little bit nervous. Just imagine holding up in the hotel overnight and then you're not safe yet because there's still sleeper zombies everywhere. You have to make sure that there's no zombies left before it's nightfall, just to be safe. It's always hard to remember what you've looted and what you haven't looted, even if you go in rows like I'm doing now. I'll do this building last so that I know it's the end point for this loot. Ooh, there's even a roof over here. I never actually knew that. But there's nothing on it, so there's no point in even going up there. Just swap these out. I want to be done with this before 12, so at least I have 4 hours to do the hotel. I'm gonna leave the safe for now. Let's just mark it on the map. I don't have time to go breaking through safes. And this bunker as well, I think I'm just gonna mark it for now, because I don't have the time to do this, to go through that wall to get to everything. Bunker tip. What? No. Okay, so I'm just quickly gonna loot the hotel off camera and see you guys back in the morning. And we are back. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to get that far, seeing as I first needed to make some stone axes, and that took a little bit of time. So as you can see, I'm still only on the first floor. I'm actually considering running to the top floor and then doing the second floor. I'm skipping two floors and then doing the very top floor, because I need to get those crates on top. So we're just gonna do that, and then when I get back to this area to loot the safes, I'll loot the rest of the hotel. It's actually a shame I can't do the hotel now, because doing it now would have ensured that I... Let's see, where's that door? If I did it now, it would ensure that my scavenging skill goes up. But unfortunately, it's gonna take too much time going through this whole hotel. As you guys can see, I have a quality 89 stone axe, and that's after combining about 20 stone axes. So I thought it was going to go a lot faster now that I have a workbench, but it seems it doesn't go that fast. Off camera, I'm going to mass craft a few stone axes and then make that those purple quality tools I need. Who knows, off camera I might just come back here before bringing you guys back and loot this whole place. But I definitely want to get those boxes on the roof with you guys. If the stone axe was 200 quality, then I'd definitely be through this place by now. I wonder how many people know of this spot on the roof. How many people have been to the roof? Huh, one was enough. Okay, so let's just quickly get through this and loot it. As soon as I'm done here, I'm going to grab everything I need and then head to the base. Ooh, calipers, awesome. This is going to be an awesome playthrough. Oh, I didn't even notice I have a steel axe. Awesome. So let's just see. Block damage, 46. Block damage, 75. I wonder if I shouldn't quickly go through this hotel, but it's going to take a while. I think I'm going to save the steel axe for trees because I need wood again. No. I'm just going to get back to the base quickly and then take the workbench and everything with me. At least we have calipers early in the game now, so we'll be able to make ammo sooner. Okay, let's just see. What do we need? What don't we need? Don't need this. Water we can get at the base. We don't put the other drop chest. Oh, it's this one. Okay, so we don't need quite a bit of these things. Painkillers I'll leave for now. I'll keep for now. Fire axe we don't need. These we need. Scrap use for the medicine skill. I want to use. I keep my wrenches with me for if I want to make the cement mixer. Let's just see from the top. I'm just going to take everything. Be right back. Okay, I'm just going to take all of this with me and then come back for this later. Luckily, I do have it marked on the map. Okay, so our base is this way. Just going to run straight there. And I should be able to cut out all of this and only have you guys back when I get to the base. But I'll bring you back if something interesting happens. I most probably have to take apart a car or two for the engine so that I can make my cement mixes. Okay guys, so now for the moment of truth. Let's see if a screamer showed up to that base that we made. If there's damage, we'll know there was a screamer. If not, there's damage. No, it just didn't upgrade this one. Okay, so far no screamer. I think one wasn't enough to actually call the screamer, so that's good. Just gonna make a little bit of space over here. As you can see, I've got another hunting rifle part, and I also got another stack of feathers just from running around. Okay, let's just put all of this away. We need a shovel and wood. Okay, so do we have upgrade stuff? Yes. I'm just gonna put the workbench over here for now. As soon as I have my workbench up, I'm gonna make a level 600 quality stone axe and stone shovel so that I can dig up all this clay over here. That should be awesome. Let's just put this here. We need the workbench. There it is, and then upgrade these two. I hear a zombie. So I wonder if there's a zombie horde coming or just one zombie horde. I can be lucky I heard the moaning. Shame I didn't get the other one while it was down. Why am I struggling so much with this guy? Just need to wait for his head to pop up, but it feels like it never does. Off camera, I'll also need to cut down quite a few trees, so the steel fire axe will come in handy. Because I need to make some spikes over here. You know why I'm struggling with the world so much? I'm not that tired. Okay, seems to be the only zombies that spawned. Hopefully. Okay, let's just quickly put everything away and then I think we'll call an episode. So, scrap this. Gonna need the wood, not gonna need these. Not gonna need this for now. Put this in the forge. We can make meat later on. Do I have any stone? No grass? No. Okay, so I'm just gonna off camera make level 600 quality stone axe, shovel, and then dig this whole place up. So by the time you guys get back, I should have that place, well, I should have started with that place upgrading it to reinforced concrete. So let's just quickly see what our skills are on. Construction tools, three away. I'm just gonna buy this one. One, two, three. I know it's a waste, but I need concrete mixing. Now with this, we can finally do some mixing and also make the concrete mixer. Also, just for crafting's sake, let's just buy a few of these. Or well, one at the moment. Okay, if you guys like this episode, please leave a like and share with your friends. If you have any comments or feedback or tips or hints for me, please leave that down below in the comment section. And if you guys are new to this channel, please remember to subscribe for more of this content. See you guys next time.